So for this lesson, we're going to be looking at hyperbolas and asymptotes. So what that means is functions that go really close to hitting the x-axis that don't hit it. So as mentioned previously, when we're looking at exponential functions actually have asymptotes as well. So a quick resource checklist before we start. You will need a calculator, a notebook and something to write notes with. Grid paper is optional because we're going to be doing some graphing and it may help you. And of course, you will need a good attitude. Even if this seems a bit difficult, you can do it. So there are going to be some visual cues on this PowerPoint. So the pen symbol means to write down the information on the slide or work through some problems on your own. I'll also be giving verbal prompts for when I want you to do either of those things as well. The calculator symbol means you're going to have to use your calculator. That one's pretty straightforward. And the little laptop symbol means that you're going to have to do something on your computer. So that could be with Excel or that could be using a Word document or something else. So our WALT for this lesson is to create and transform hyperbolic functions and explore asymptotes. That's a silent P in asymptotes, in case you were wondering. So I'm looking for you guys to engage in the learning. Once again, pay attention to the language used during transformation and pay really careful note to what an asymptote really is. So it can get a bit complicated between a hyperbola and an asymptote, but if we go slowly and really think about what we're writing or looking at, the definitions become quite clear. So asymptotes and hyperbolic functions actually have properties that can help us understand other fields of study. So the idea of never actually reaching a point or a certain number is a string of mathematics that applies in plants, in animals, and even stuff like pi, like the number pi, although I'm sure you could find hyperbolas in an actual pi if you wanted to. So a hyperbolic function forms a graph called a hyperbola. So this function is in the form y equals a divided by x. Now, a really important property is that x cannot be zero in this function. So we would say this function has an asymptote at zero. So asymptotes will never be reached by the function. So there's no circumstance where we can get an output when we input zero, because any number divided by zero is actually undefined. It gets nothing. Our calculators blow up. We don't know what that answer is. So a really important function property of hyperbolas in asymptotes is that as x approaches zero, some very interesting stuff happens. So now I want you guys to complete the following table for the hyperbolic function y equals 1 divided by x. Now I've already filled in two answers for you. So when x is 1, we do 1 divided by 1 and we get 1. That was pretty simple. But when we do 0, 1 divided by 0, we get undefined. So I've done a sad face here to show that I'm sad that it's undefined. So can you fill in the rest of that table using these numbers up here? So pause the video and fill in that table. Okay, hopefully you got the same answers that I did. So 1 divided by 0.9, actually get 1.1 recurring. So it's a little bit more than 1. That's not as interesting. So when we do 1 divided by 0.5, we get 2. Okay. So we've doubled. Interesting. So when we do 1 divided by 0.1, we get 10. So as we get closer to zero, our numbers start to get larger and larger. So 0.01, we get 100. 0.001, we get 1,000, and we get 10,000. So as we approach zero in our x, in our domain, our range or our y values skyrocket. So if you entered a really, 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 really small number, in here, you'll get a really, 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 really large number here. So that's what happens around an asymptote. So that's a property of hyperbolic functions. So there is a general formula for hyperbolic functions. So that's y equals a divided by x minus h plus k. So this formula is used to apply transformations to hyperbolic functions, where k is the vertical translation and h is the horizontal translation. So just like with our exponential functions, we can translate the function up and down and left and right. Okay, so now we're going to look at applying some of those transformations to a hyperbola. So this is what a hyperbola looks like on a graph. So this is the graph of y equals 1 divided by x. And see, we've got a table of values down here. So as we get positive, higher positive, our answer gets smaller. Really, really close. As we get more negative, our answer also gets smaller. And as we get to 0, see, yeah, we get really, really steep numbers. So we're going to look at the vertical translation first. So we're going to change our k value here. So if I change this k value to 1, that moves our hyperbola up 1 unit. So you can see it's kind of difficult to see, but it does move it up 1 unit. And you can see in our table of values is that our asymptote is still at 0. So if we go up to 2, it's still at 0. And if we get negative values for k, see our function is a subtract 1 now, we move downwards. So when we change our h value, that's our horizontal translation. So I change this to a 1, it moves it to the right. You can see our asymptote has actually moved. It's no longer at 0. On this table of values, there is no 1 column because asymptote's now at 1. Because if x is 1 here, 1 subtract 1 is 0, and that doesn't work. So if we make it 2, we can see our asymptote is at 2. And if we make h a negative number, 1 over x plus 1, that moves it the other way. And here, x cannot be negative 2. Because negative 2 plus 2 is 0. So that's how we apply the transformations to some hyperbolas. So this is in exercise 9.7 for your online textbook if you want to look at that. So just some notes while we're graphing hyperbolas. So make sure you have a table of values. That's our bread and butter of graphing. Make sure you use plenty of brackets in your calculator too when you're entering in your functions. So if we've got an x minus 1 underneath the 1, we've got to use the correct amount of brackets in our calculator so that we do that properly. And remember that if a function asymptotes at 0, it's never going to reach 0. If it asymptotes at 1, it's never going to reach 1. So when we're doing our graphs, make sure that we don't intersect the asymptotes. So that wraps up asymptotes and hyperbolas. So I want you guys to complete the worksheet, hyperbolas and asymptotes. Leave any questions on OneNote, and remember that you can email me or your other teachers. And a little fun activity to kind of visualize what an asymptote is. So stand a meter from a wall, exactly, approximately, as long as you're about a meter. Then halve your distance from the wall. Halve your distance again. If you keep exactly halving your distance, will you ever reach the wall? Now that's a tricky question, but that is the concept of asymptotes. So have fun. Remember that sometimes we'll never reach a point, but we can still get very, very close.